The Papal Basilica of St. Peter in the Vatican is an Italian Renaissance church in Vatican City, the papal enclave within the city of Rome. Designed principally by Donato Bramante, Michelangelo, Carlo Maderno and Gian Lorenzo Bernini, St. Peter's is the most renowned work of Renaissance architecture and the largest church in the world. While it is neither the mother church of the Catholic Church nor the cathedral of the Diocese of Rome, St. Peter's is regarded as one of the holiest Catholic shrines. It has been described as holding a unique position in the Christian world and is the greatest of all churches of Christendom. Catholic tradition holds that the basilica is the burial site of St. Peter, one of Jesus's apostles, and also the first pope. St. Peter's tomb is supposedly directly below the high altar of the basilica. For this reason, many popes have been interred at St. Peter's since the early Christian period, and there has been a church on this site since the time of the Roman Emperor Constantine the Great. Construction of the present basilica, which would replace old St. Peter's Basilica from the 4th century C, began on 18 April 1506, and was completed on 18 November 1626. St. Peter's is famous as a place of pilgrimage and for its liturgical functions. The Pope presides at a number of liturgies throughout the year, drawing audiences of 15,000 to over 80,000 people, either within the Basilica or the adjoining St. Peter's Square. St. Peter's has many historical associations with the early Christian Church, the Papacy, the Protestant Reformation and Catholic Counter-Reformation and numerous artists, especially Michelangelo. As a work of architecture, it is regarded as the greatest building of its age. St. Peter's is one of the four churches in the world that hold the rank of major basilica, all four of which are in Rome. Contrary to popular misconception, it is not a cathedral, because it is not the seat of a bishop. The Cathedra of the Pope as Bishop of Rome is in the Archbasilica of St. John Lateran.
The Trevi Fountain is a fountain in the Trevi district in Rome, Italy, designed by Italian architect Nicolas Alvi and completed by Pietro Bracci. Standing 26.3 meters high and 49.15 meters wide, it is the largest Baroque fountain in the city and one of the most famous fountains in the world. The fountain has appeared in several notable films, including Federico Fellini's La Dolce Vita and the eponymous Three Coins in the Fountain. In 1629, Pope Urban VIII, finding the earlier fountain insufficiently dramatic, asked Gian Lorenzo Bernini to sketch possible renovations, but the project was abandoned when the Pope died. Though Bernini's project was never constructed, there are many Bernini touches in the fountain as it exists today. An early, influential model by Pietro da Cortona, preserved in the Albertina, Vienna, also exists, as do various early 18th century sketches, most unsigned, as well as a project attributed to Nicola Michetti, one attributed to Ferdinando Fuga, and a French design by Edmond Boucherdon. In 1730, Pope Clement XII organized a contest in which Nicolas Alvi initially lost to Alessandro Galilei, but due to the outcry in Rome over the fact that a Florentine won, Alvi was awarded the commission anyway. Work began in 1732 and the fountain was completed in 1762, long after Alvi's death, when Pietro Bracci's Oceanus was set in the central niche. The Trevi Fountain was finished in 1762 by Giuseppe Panini, who substituted the present allegories for planned sculptures of Agrippa and Trivia, the Roman Virgin. It was officially opened and inaugurated on May 22 by Pope Clement XIII. The majority of the pieces made from travertine stone, quarried near Tivoli, about 35 kilometers east of Rome. The fountain was refurbished in 1998. The stonework was scrubbed and all cracks and other areas of deterioration were repaired by skilled artisans, and the fountain was equipped with recirculating pumps. In January 2013, it was announced that the Italian fashion company Fendi would sponsor a 20-month, €2.2 million restoration of the fountain. It was to be the most thorough restoration in the fountain's history. Restoration work began in June 2014 and was completed in November 2015. The fountain was reopened with an official ceremony on the evening of November 3, 2015. The restoration included the installation of more than 100 LED lights to improve the nighttime illumination of the fountain.
Val di Noto, English, Province of Noto, is a historical and geographical area encompassing the southeastern third of Sicily. It is dominated by the limestone Iberian Plateau. Historically, it was one of the three valleys of Sicily. The oldest recorded settlement in the Val di Noto was the ancient town of Acri, near Palazzolo Acride, which was founded in 664 BC. It was the first colony of the Corinthian settlement at Syracuse. The settlements of the Val di Noto were completely destroyed by the enormous 1693 Sicily earthquake. Following the earthquake, many towns were rebuilt on entirely new sites, such as Noto and Gramicale. The rulers of the time, the kings of Spain, granted the nobleman Giuseppe Lanza special authority to redesign the damaged towns, which he achieved by sympathetically designing the new towns in a Baroque and Renaissance style. The new settlements were redesigned to have a town square in the center and to spread out in a radial pattern from there. Major buildings like churches, cloisters and palaces were built as focal points for the new streets, and the streets themselves were laid out in a grid pattern. Many of the individual towns were rebuilt to have a unique character, such as the town of Gramicale, which was built in a hexagonal shape with a town square in the center, consisting of the parish and town hall. The towns were rebuilt in what came to be known as the Sicilian Baroque style, the most notable of which is the town of Noto itself, which is now a popular tourist destination due to its fine Baroque architecture. Archaeology: the ruined town of Angie was rediscovered by the historian Thomas Fuentes in the 16th century. Further excavations in the early 19th century by Baron Gabriel Ali unearthed important artifacts from the early history of eastern Sicily. In June 2002, UNESCO inscribed the towns of the Val di Noto on the World Heritage List as representing the culmination and final flowering of Baroque art in Europe. The listed towns are called Alteroni, Militello and Val di Catania, Catania, Modica, Noto, Palazzolo Acride, Ragusa, and Sicli. The Valle dei Templi is an archaeological site in Agrigento, Sicily, southern Italy. It is one of the most outstanding examples of Greater Greece art and architecture, and is one of the main attractions of Sicily as well as a national monument of Italy. The area was included in the UNESCO World Heritage Site list in 1997. Much of the excavation and restoration of the temples was due to the efforts of archaeologist Domenico Antonio Lo Fosso Pietrasantu, 1783-1863, who was the Duke of Cerrato Falco from 1809 through 1812. The archaeological park and landscape of the Valley of the Temples is the largest archaeological site in the world with 1,300 hectares. The term valley is a misnomer, the site being located on a ridge outside the town of Agrigento. The valley includes remains of seven temples, all in Doric style. The ascription of the names, apart from that of the Olympian, are a mere tradition established in Renaissance times. The temples are Temple of Concordia, whose name comes from a Latin inscription found nearby, and which was built in the 5th century BC. Turned into a church in the 6th century AD, it is now one of the best preserved in the valley. Temple of Juno, also built in the 5th century BC. It was burned in 406 BC by the Carthaginians. Temple of Heracles, who was one of the most venerated deities in the ancient Acragas. It is the most ancient in the valley, destroyed by an earthquake. It consists today of only 8 columns. Temple of Olympian Zeus, built in 480 BC, to celebrate the city-state's victory over Carthage. It is characterized by the use of large-scale atlases. Temple of Castor and Pollux. Despite its remains including only 4 columns, it is now the symbol of modern Agrigento. Temple of Vulcan, also dating from the 5th century BC. It is thought to have been one of the most imposing constructions in the valley. It is now, however, one of the most eroded. Temple of Asclepius, located far from the ancient town's walls, it was the goal of pilgrims seeking cures for illness. The valley is also home to the so-called Tomb of Theron, a large tough monument of pyramidal shape. Scholars suppose it was built to commemorate the Romans killed in the Second Punic War.
Vatican City is a country located within the city of Rome. With an area of approximately 44 hectares, 110 acres, and a population of 1,000, it is the smallest state in the world by both area and population. However, formally it is not sovereign, with sovereignty being held by the Holy See. It is an ecclesiastical or sacerdotal monarchical state, a type of theocracy, ruled by the Bishop of Rome, the Pope. The highest state functionaries are all Catholic clergy of various national origins. Since the return of the popes from Avignon in 1377, they have generally resided at the Apostolic Palace within what is now Vatican City, although at times residing instead in the Quirinal Palace in Rome or elsewhere. Vatican City is distinct from the Holy See, which dates back to early Christianity and is the main episcopal see of 1.2 billion Latin and Eastern Catholic adherents around the globe. Within Vatican City are religious and cultural sites such as St. Peter's Basilica, the Sistine Chapel and the Vatican Museums. They feature some of the world's most famous paintings and sculptures. The unique economy of Vatican City is supported financially by the sale of postage stamps and tourist mementos, fees for admission to museums, and the sale of publications. Vatican City is home to some of the most famous art in the world. St. Peter's Basilica, whose successive architects include Bramante, Michelangelo, Giacomo della Porta, Maderno, and Bernini, is a renowned work of Renaissance architecture. The Sistine Chapel is famous for its frescoes, which include works by Perugino, Domenico Ghirlandaio and Botticelli, as well as the Ceiling and Last Judgment by Michelangelo. Artists who decorated the interiors of the Vatican include Raphael and Francis Angelico. The Vatican Apostolic Library and the collections of the Vatican Museums are of the highest historical, scientific and cultural importance. In 1984, the Vatican was added by UNESCO to the list of World Heritage Sites. It is the only one to consist of an entire state. Furthermore, it is the only site to date registered with the UNESCO as a center containing monuments in the International Register of Cultural Property under special protection according to the 1954 Hague Convention for the Protection of Cultural Property in the Event of Armed Conflict.
Verona is a city on the Adige River in Veneto, Italy, with approximately 265,000 inhabitants and one of the seven provincial capitals of the region. It is the second largest city municipality in the region and the third largest in northeast Italy. It is one of the main tourist destinations in northern Italy, owing to its artistic heritage, several annual fairs, shows, and operas, such as the Lyrical Season and the Arena, the ancient amphitheater built by the Romans. Three of Shakespeare's plays are set in Verona: Romeo and Juliet, The Two Gentlemen of Verona, and The Taming of the Shrew. It is unknown if Shakespeare ever visited Verona early at all, but his plays have lured many visitors to Verona and surrounding cities many times over. The city has been awarded World Heritage Site status by UNESCO because of its urban structure and architecture. Verona is famous for its Roman amphitheater, the Arena, found in the city's largest piazza, the Piazza Brat. Completed around 30 AD, it is the third largest in Italy after Rome's Colosseum and the Arena at Capua. It measures 139 meters long and 110 meters wide, and could seat some 25,000 spectators in its 44 tiers of marble seats. The Ludi, shows and gladiator games, performed within its walls were so famous that they attracted spectators from far beyond the city. The current two-story facade is actually the internal support for the tiers, only a fragment of the original outer perimeter wall in white and pink limestone from Valpolicella, with three stories remains. There is also a variety of other Roman monuments to be found in the town, such as the Roman Theatre of Verona. This theatre was built in the 1st century BC. but through the ages had fallen in disuse and had been built upon to provide housing. In the 18th century, Andrea Munga, a wealthy Viennese, bought all the houses that in time had been built over the theater, demolished them, and saved the monument. It originally straddled the main Roman road into the city, now the Corso Cavour. It was demolished by French troops in 1805 and rebuilt in 1932. San Zeno Basilica, like many other Viennese churches, is built with alternating layers of white stone and bricks. Nearby is the Porta Borsari, an archway at the end of Corso Porta Borsari. This is the facade of a 3rd century gate in the original Roman city walls. Today, it is lined with several Renaissance palazzi and the ancient church of Santi Apostoli, a few meters from Piazza dell'Erba.
The Verona Arena is a Roman amphitheater in Piazza Bra in Verona, Italy, built in the 1st century. It is still in use today, and is internationally famous for the large-scale opera performances given there. It is one of the best-preserved ancient structures of its kind. In ancient times, nearly 30,000 people was the housing capacity of the arena. Nowadays, for security reasons, the maximum attendance is 15,000 people. The building itself was built in AD 30 on a site which was then beyond the city walls. The ludi, shows and games, staged there were so famous that spectators came from many other places, often far away, to witness them. The amphitheater could host more than 30,000 spectators in ancient times. The round facade of the building was originally composed of white and pink limestone from Valpolicella, but after a major earthquake in 1117, which almost completely destroyed the structure's outer ring, except for the so-called ala wing, the stone was quarried for reuse in other buildings. Nevertheless, it impressed medieval visitors to the city, one of whom considered it to have been a labyrinth, without ingress or egress. Ciriaco d'Ancona was filled with admiration for the way it had been built, and Giovanni Antonio Panteo's civic panegyric De Laudibus Veroni, 1483, remarked that it struck the viewer as a construction that was more than human. The first interventions to recover the arena's function as a theater began during the Renaissance. Some operatic performances were later mounted in the building during the 1850s, owing to its outstanding acoustics. And in 1913, operatic performances in the arena commenced in earnest due to the zeal and initiative of the Italian opera tenor Giovanni Zanatello and the impresario Otton Rivato. The first 20th century operatic production at the arena, a staging of Giuseppe Verdi's Aida, took place on 10 August of that year, to mark the birth of Verdi 100 years before in 1813. In modern times, at least 4 productions, sometimes up to 6, are mounted each year between June and August. Modern-day travelers are advised that admission tickets to sit on the arena's stone steps are much cheaper to buy than tickets giving access to the padded chairs available on lower levels. Candles are distributed to the audience and lit after sunset around the arena.
Hadrian's Villa is a large Roman archaeological complex at Tivoli, Italy. It is the property of the Republic of Italy, and has been directed and run by the Polo Museo del Lazio since December 2014. Hadrian's Villa is a vast area of land with many pools, baths, fountains and classical Greek architecture set in what would have been a mixture of landscaped gardens, wilderness areas and cultivated farmlands. The buildings are constructed in travertine, brick, lime, pozzolana, and tufa. The complex contains over 30 buildings, covering an area of at least a square kilometer, 250 acres, of which much is still unexcavated. The site was chosen due to its abundant waters and readily available aqueducts that passed through Rome, including Annio Vitus, Annio Nobis, Aqua Marcia, and Aqua Claudia. The area was known as the location of villas before Hadrian obtained the property. It was, and still is, a picturesque area conveniently close to Rome but seemingly detached and separate. The villa was the greatest Roman example of an Alexandrian garden, recreating a sacred landscape. Many beautiful artifacts have been unearthed and restored at the villa, such as marble statues of Antinous, Hadrian's deified lover, accidentally drowned in Egypt, and mosaics from the theater and baths. A lifelike mosaic depicted a group of doves around a bowl, with one drinking, seems to be a copy of a work by Sossius of Pergamon as described by Pliny the Elder. It has in turn been widely copied. Many copies of Greek statues, such as the Wounded Amazon, have been found, and even Egyptian-style interpretations of Roman gods and vice versa. Most of these have been taken to Rome for preservation and restoration, and can be seen at the Musei Capitolini or the Musei Vaticani. However, many were also excavated in the 18th century by antiquities dealers such as Pironesi and Gavin Hamilton to sell to grand tourists and antiquarians such as Charles Townley, and so are in major antiquities collections elsewhere in Europe and North America. Hadrian's Villa is a UNESCO World Heritage Site and important cultural and archaeological site. It is also a major tourist destination along with the nearby Villa d'Este and the town of Tivoli. The Academy of the Villa was placed on the 100 Most Endangered Sites 2006 list of the World Monuments Watch because of the rapid deterioration of the ruins.
The Villa d'Este is a 16th century villa in Tivoli, near Rome, famous for its terraced hillside Italian Renaissance garden and especially for its profusion of fountains. It is now an Italian state museum, and is listed as a UNESCO World Heritage Site. Today the villa is entered from a doorway on the Piazza Trento, next to the entrance of the Church of Santa Maria Maggiore. In the time of Ippolito d'Este, this entrance was rarely used. Visitors arrived at the bottom of the gardens, and ascended, step by step, to the villa, viewing the fountains and statuary. The current door dates to 1521, to the period before Ippolito. The foyer inside the door has a painted vault which was once covered with paintings, which were largely destroyed by the bombing during World War II. It was decorated with monochrome scenes from the Old Testament, a few of which, including the sacrifice of Isaac, still can be seen. They date to the period between 1563 to 65. And were probably designed by Girolamo Musano. Next room, the Hall of the Stories of Solomon, shows scenes from Life of King Solomon, set in frames painted to resemble marble. They also are attributed to Musano and his craftsmen, is also from about 1565. The massive head of travertine stone is on display here, which until the 18th century was in the garden. The courtyard is placed where the original cloister of the convent was located. It was constructed in 1566-67, and is surrounded by a gallery. The centerpiece of the courtyard is the Fountain of Venus, the only fountain in the villa which retains its original appearance and decoration. The fountain, designed by Raffaello Sangallo in 1568-69, is framed by two Doric columns, and crowned by a 4th-century marble bust of the Emperor Constantine. The central element of the fountain, the Roman statue of a sleeping Venus, made in the 4th or 5th centuries AD. The fame and glory of the Villa d'Este was above all established by its extraordinary system of fountains, 51 fountains and nymphs, 398 spouts, 364 water jets, 64 waterfalls, and 220 basins, fed by 875 meters of canals, channels and cascades, and all working entirely by the force of gravity, without pumps.